easily bothered by the cloying attentions of the male sex. Well, here's the solution for you. Get Ruth Sherwood's new bestseller, 100 Easy Ways to Lose a Man. Chapter 1. Now, the first way to lose a man. You met a charming fellow and you're out for a spin. The motor fades and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, what a romantic spot we're in. Just get out, crawl in the car, tell us the gasket, and fix it 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game. You sit knee to knee. He says the last guy up and back will want, you'll see. Don't say, oh, where's your buddy? These games too hard for little me. Just say, what? What are you, nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, you'll walk right into a triple play, just like it happened in the fifth game of the World Series in 1923. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. You'll never try for a second base. From the start, he whispers, you're the one, the woman in my heart. Don't say, I don't want you. It's never, never hard. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, make the use of the word whom imperative, which I can easily show you by